Hey guys, what's good? Mike here, Laker Talk. Want to get my thoughts on the Lakers offseason and what's coming up next for the Lakers. I know it's been a minute since my last video. A lot of people hitting me up. Mike, what's going on with the videos? You know, to be honest with you, the Lakers were in tank mode. I needed to focus on some other stuff. I needed a break from the Lakers sort of like dwindling down into like really not being competitive. So we're in the middle of the playoffs right now. Lakers are on vacation. You hear a lot of rumors going on. Paul George, he's walking in Disneyland, people recording him saying come to the Lakers and all this stuff. So here's what's going on. So we got the Paul George rumors and the craziness going on right now. Obviously, Paul George out of the playoffs. Rumor is he wants to come to the Lakers. He can only come to the Lakers in a trade, right? What do we know about the Lakers? Overall, Paul George alone is not going to help the Lakers do anything. He's going to improve us, but he's not going to be the guy that's going to take us deep into the playoffs, right? If we get Paul George, we're going to have to give up some assets. We're going to have a lot of excitement. The fan base will be excited. Now we have an all-star to build around, right? That's the ultimate, that's what Paul George is going to bring. Again, he's going to bring some excitement. He's a great player. He's a good player, but at his best, he's a number two. He's like a number two player. He's not a number one star. So what does that mean? It's not that we're going to be continuing to look for our number one. It's just that, hey, we acquire Paul George. Now we need another all-star to build around him, right? Whether we sign like a Blake Griffin or whatever, what have you, right? A lot of stuff will have to happen for those things to take place. But the point is Paul George is out there. And is it a possibility? Sure, we will have to trade a lot of assets. What do we have on the Lakers right now? The only clear asset the Lakers have right now is Brandon Ingram, bar none. Everybody else is on the table, okay? I mean, go down the list, D'Angelo Russell, Julius Randle, Jordan Clarkson, Larry Nance Jr., Zubac. Anybody you want to talk about is on the table. And why is that? Because no matter what those players can become, especially D'Angelo Russell, like the potential they have, Julius Randle, whatever, you know he's not a leader right now, okay? He's going to probably be something down the road. He's a decent player, D'Angelo Russell, that is, but he's not leading the Lakers. He's not the clear leader of the Lakers. Still question marks out on whether D'Angelo Russell can lead the team. So is he a potential asset that we can package for Paul George? Sure. Julius Randle's on the block, Jordan Clarkson's on the block, anybody, right, to acquire Paul George. Now, a lot of this is predicated on the draft coming up in a couple weeks. If we stay within the top three, obviously we have a really big asset in any of those top three players, right? Josh Jackson, Lonzo Ball, Markelle Fultz, or whatever, right? We have an asset. We're obviously going to draft one of those players, right? Or that's going to give us an option to package that for an all-star, like a Paul George, right? Do you do that? Sure, everything's on the table. It's going to take several years for any one of those prospects right now coming out of the college to be any sort of value to lead your team right away, okay? It's going to take several years for that to happen. Young kids, fresh, they got to learn the NBA game. And I don't see any clear franchise star that's going to come out right now like a Karl Anthony Towns that's going to be a full-blown all-star right off the bat. No, it's going to take some time. So would I package one of those assets? Possibly. If we land in the top three and pick a Lonzo Ball, is he going to help us right away? I don't know how he's going to fare at the NBA level next year. Is it going to take him time to come around? Sure, but having said all that, Paul George is out there, the draft is coming up, so we cross our fingers. If we miss that draft, we're going to be in the hole for another 2 years, in my opinion. So that's that. You hear a lot with Rob Pelinka and Magic Johnson talking a lot about getting in shape. What they're talking about in terms of getting in shape, they're really taking a shot at lazy rookies. In my opinion, rookies tend to be lazy and focusing on other stuff outside the NBA game. And what I think they're talking about is they want players to, when you look at like LeBron James, you look at video of LeBron James, he's a champion. He's always taking care of his body. The dude is playing for what, how many years, and he's never injured? That's so out of this world. It's not even funny. The fact that he can play that long and not ever be injured. What they're talking about, Rob Pelinka and Magic, is that they want players to have that level of focus for the Lakers. And you don't get that today in all the young kids that we have in this league. You know, they're all like taking pictures and doing this and doing that, and they're not really focused on their body. You know, D'Angelo Russell, you know, can look a little flabby here and there. You know, Zubats is flabby, right? So we just need our players, young players. You know, Brandon Ingram needs to stay in the gym and get stronger, and so forth. And so we just need our players. They need our players. They want our players to focus on basketball. And basically, I think it's a shot at these young rookies and saying, stop getting injured. Stop being lazy. You know, but if you don't focus on your body, you're going to be injured. You're going to be, you know, sore knees and this and that and the third. But if you train your ligaments, you stretch and you go through, you know, daily regimens and things like that, you're going to be more focus, you're going to have less injuries, and you're going to be, you know, really focusing on basketball. So I think it's really a shot at saying we're tired of just not being competitive and not focusing on championship level type of basketball. Anyway, having said that, where the Lakers need to go, I think from here, is we need to make a big move in the offseason. We got, we just can't, in my opinion, we can't stay steady and just keep grinding. And that ain't gonna work. We gotta make big leaps every single year. Whatever that may be, we need to make an improvement. Not just a little small incremental improvement. We need to make a big improvement and then keep building from there. I think the Lakers right now, next year, regardless of who we get, let's say we're around 35, 37 wins, okay? That's decent. Yeah, it's not playoff level. We gotta get to a level like right now, like the Portland Trail Blazers, when they're winning around 41 games, that's going to take a couple years, in my opinion, for us to get there. And I think we need to get to that point where we're battling Denver, Portland for that eighth spot. And then from there, we get a taste of the playoff blood or whatnot. And then we're like, what's the next move for us to build? What's the next piece for us to add? Is that, you know, acquiring another, you know, big all-star at some point. And then that's going to move us in the middle of the pack in terms of, like, you know, getting us to, like, maybe the second round. And now we're competing with the Utahs and the Houston Rockets, and the San Antonio Spurs or whatnot. You could foresee that in maybe 3 years, right? If we acquire the right pieces and whatnot. But if we don't, if we just stay pat, you're looking at 5 years down the road before we even reach those levels. So that's what I see about the Lakers right now. Not a lot of news going on in the Lakers, but in Lakerland right now. But Paul George is out there. The draft is coming up. Everything lies on this draft and see where we go from there. And then all the moves we make once we acquire, if we acquire that pick. And what happens after that. That's my thoughts right now on the Lakers. More to come. Hit me up in the comments below. Thanks for watching my videos. And hit me up on Twitter, guys. Mike Sports LA. We'll talk soon. Peace.